Right, I'm back over on the south side of, no, the north side of the wood now. Leaving the older part, spookier part, where I saw the fox, where I heard the loud banging and crashing noises deep in the wood there, which I didn't go too far to investigate. But there were more bluebells about than I was expecting, and wild garlic. I don't think I ever see wild garlic this side, so I was a bit taken back by that. I thought, oh, fancy that. Now, there aren't an abundant of bluebells, are there? This is normally the really bluebelly side of the wood, but it might be better further down. So this is a walk that used to be a little tiny path. More and more people have been coming here since COVID, encouraged to walk, get out in the air. And I've been coming here now. Well, I came here a long, long time ago in the late 90s, when Zara lived in Weston, we came over here. We walked down to Cusoke, Sand Bay area, and went in the pub. And it was around about the time of the Blair Witch Project, and it was really spooky. We actually spooked ourselves. It was me, Georgia, and Zara came down through the wood. It was quite creepy, actually, I remember that. I did keep a tape recording once, but I had to use it for Family Tree. Yeah, I should have kept that, really. That would have been really interesting. But look at that, there's a nice little blue haze there. I'll just turn it off and take a picture, hold on. Yeah, let's get that. Yeah, I've been coming here for, I'd say at least 2007 we started exploring the wood, me and Brandy. When we lived in, we came to live in Western Town. And just started to gradually come up the wood. Gradually finding the paths. Took several years. And Brandy was my companion for quite a few of those years, you know, 6 or 7 years, Brandy and I walked this wood together. And I'm glad she was my companion, because I used to be quite a bit scared at in those days, actually. I was a bit scared going in the wood on my own. I mean, even now, I keep on guard, I keep alert. You have to. And Look at that scene there. So I run out of battery soon, again. So basically I'm just doing a little bit of videoing of this part of the wood, the bluebell area, because this display will not last very long. On it, no. It doesn't last very long. The bluebells are out. It's magical, isn't it? There's something magical about bluebells. Now it goes very, very dull here for a while, and then in a minute when we get further down, in theory, and usually, sometimes I go that way, but I'm going to go skirt the edge today, we come across a little spell of them. But that was a good spell back there, really. That was a good display. But I can't see many here. Not even the odd one, look. Very, very sparse, isn't it? Very, very sparse, Sheila. Is this normal? No, because as we get down, I can already see the blue. So there's a very sparse area here. Why that is, who knows? Is it colder? You know, that sort of thing. They probably get the afternoon sunlight here, I think. Yeah, look at this. I'm appearing now. beautiful, isn't it? Lots and lots of bluebells, everybody. I just took some
lovely little area there, look.
Lovely little area here. The bluebells seem to like this area here. And what happens, we see them for a bit longer and then they go. They go again. Another little area there, look. Freshens you up when you go. So this is the first time I've been up this end in April anyway. I think April, the month of April has just flashed by. And like I say, so when October comes, I always look forward to April. The sound of the birds, the greenery, the lush green freshness of spring, and the bluebells and the peace after a long winter, which obviously we haven't had a harsh winter at all. But I look forward to this day in the winter. I really do look forward to it so much. And it's going, it scares me. When April's going, it scares me. Because April is the hope month. May is similar. And then we're into the summer and we get our summer. Sometimes it doesn't last very long. Or we get one massive heat wave. But this month, April, I love April. I'm already feeling sad that it's going to be gone. Last day tomorrow. Last day in 2024 of our April. Which has been a very grey month. It's been a sad April. But today it's leaving us. Today and tomorrow. I think it's supposed to pour with rain, but that's April showers. The bluebells are saying hi, Sheila, and we'll be going soon. If you want to see us elsewhere, you'll need to get out. Oh no. I know I will. It's funny, as I get older, like each part of the year has its value, its season, and there's so many people passing on. I feel like the train's going, the ship is sailing, with all the people, all the things in my life, whether it's pop stars, film stars, people I sort of know, and they're all going. We're all going at once, almost. It's scary, really. We've had our time. I mean, I'm open to live longer, of course. But when I've had this bad breathing problem, it does make you wonder. But well, like I say, April. Come up here and enjoy April. I love you, April. A lot of the trees are still asleep. They're always guarded, the trees. These little ones can come out because they're protected, they're low down. The big trees wait. They wait. You can get snow in April. But Wednesday, May will be here. Mayday, mayday. But I shall miss April. I haven't been out a lot in it. I had one walk over the Quantocks, West Bagborough to Crocombe. A lovely walk, passing through Triscombe, passing the hamlet of Triscombe, the little tiny hamlet of Little Quantock. just a gentle walk on the base of the Quantocks. I really enjoyed it. I wanted to get that walk done because obviously, as people know, I need to get to Holford. I'd be out Holford a lot more if I still had a vehicle. I miss being able to get out there as off at least once a month. I miss it. I feel at home there. It's like my spirit's there. I sometimes think maybe I should go there when I go, not Glastonbury. It's difficult. I always wanted to go to the Quantocks, it's true. Anyway, we won't talk about that now. Let's just turn off and take some pictures. Folks, well, on the others, we just crossed over the main track that leads down to Cewstoke and Sand Bay. We've crossed over to, we're still on the north side, but we're heading west. There's so many birds singing as I walk here. And we're entering what I call a cathedral of trees. Beautiful. Look how lush this is. Now, I videoed this in the winter when it was bare and quiet. I'm now videoing at this absolute start of spring, really. And everything is coming out. And it will continue to come out and out and out. Lush lime, pale green leaves, full of life, full of photosynthesis, pumping out the oxygen for us, making our whole little world so beautiful. And April depicts this moment. April predicts, not predicts, depicts this moment in the calendar of beauty, of freshness, and like I say, of hope. And it's leaving us like this and reminding us that although it's been a grey month, it's leaving us with this beauty. And still the bluebells will start, still appear. And once I get round the corner in a minute, if the battery lasts, we'll come across the tall trees, what I've called a cathedral of trees. Tall trees, some of them still holding fast, because they know the start of May can be dodgy. And I've really needed this walk. I've missed it. Like I said, when I lived further close to the wood, I was up here a lot. I'm talking about 3-odd times a week. Now, I'd be lucky if I get up here once a week. Because you have to make that bit more effort. You have to walk right across town and uphill. And so sometimes you think, oh, I can't really be bothered today, even though you want to, and you know it would be good for you. The beach doesn't have the same appeal. I mean, I went to uphill last week. I had a lovely walk by the river down to the Bring Down Inn, where I had this long chat with this bloke, only about 4 or 5 years older than me. Man of the world, I called him. An old welder man who worked all over the planet. Oil rigs, all sorts of places he worked. And he had lots of tales to tell. And I told him he should do an audio book and tell his story. Because he's one of a type or a kind. Those sort of men that did that. He called himself a nomad. Because he travelled with his work. He had a family and everything, you know. Don't know if you ever saw him. But, yeah, he was very interesting. Very interesting man. Not totally well, but he'd been a very big, strong man once. A welder. And other skills. He had lots of skills in all sorts of areas that he needed and he got the qualifications for in his work. He could put his hand to anything. He was still working. He was working in some place where they have fish, some sort of lake, and he had his double caravan, and he was enjoying his peaceful existence like that, with a bit of work and somewhere to live. It's funny what you talk about when you're out, when you're reflecting. Like I said, reflective journal, visual diary. And here we have it, folks. Now, these trees aren't fully out yet. The cathedral of trees. But it will happen soon.